Hello and welcome to another Nikomedia tutorial. So I hope you all had a wonderful Christmas time, and I found time now a little bit, and got a question about this animation here from Jean-Michel Fairbeck. Sorry if I pronounce it wrong. So this is this one here. And this shouldn't take all too much time, so I think we can do this now. And yeah, let's do this. Yep, something to relax, I would say. So good, let's start. Yep, let's start with a tube. So as so often, I did not really try this, but we did something like this in other tutorials and techniques of this, so we shouldn't be all too 32 height of 10, don't need any segments, and here 330 to 100, we have a nice thing here. Okay, and I just need a half of that, so I go to slice here, bang, and that's it. Sorry. The next step, we need another one of this, so this is 10 high, so I go with this 5 in the Y, so it should be here on the floor. Yep, that looks nice. And with control and drag it down here, so we have a copy, and this bring to -5. Okay, now we have this these two parts here. Okay, and I simply bring this in we bring this in a null object, so null. Bring this to in a null object, and yeah, that's okay for now, I think. Let's name this tube 1. So then I make a copy of this. Name it tube 2, of course you can name it however you want, and make these two tubes. I select both of them and make the object here to 70, so I make it 30 centimeter less, so 70 and 100 here, and we get this, and I make another one, third tube 3, make smaller again, so let's say 30 less, so 40 and 70, looks nice so far. And then last but not least, we will put it later a cylinder in the middle, but now let's finish with the cubes here. I don't want this triangle here, and so I have to make it editable to remove the triangle. Before I do this, I will save it under rotating cubes. So, and now, yeah, let's make the tubes editable here. So I select all the tubes, come on, and hit C on the keyboard. Bon, all is editable now. And they are still all selected, so I go to my polygon selection. We have all selected, and just right click, and here we have untriangulate. So and now you see we have everything without triangles. This is the first thing I want. The second thing is, why I do this is to make a nice bevel around our tubes here. I will show you what I mean. So when I have these triangles and I make here, for instance, I select my tube now here and with shift click on bevel deformer. And I want to bevel the edges, yes, but I want to a solid bevel. You will see I get a problem here. Let's hide the other ones here for the moment. I don't get a nice bevel here. I want to put everything later on in a subdivision surface, so this looks okay, but you know, I don't like this ugly bevels here. You can do it like this if you want, but you see we have triangles here, and when we try to bevel it with here is a uniform bevel, this will not work as well. This looks then like this. So it's all not really nice. As I said, if you say okay, you don't see it at the end, but as I said, I don't want it, so I make it now editable and then work with the bevel. So again, so I just untriangulate the line now. Whoops. And U is untriangulate. So, and when I make now this bevel deformer, you see we get a very nice bevel here. This looks now much better. And that is the reason why I want to make it edible. As said, you don't have to, but I do it. Good, next step, let's copy this bevel to here, to the other things, and so, and make it visible again. Now we bring all of our tubes here in a new null. So let's make a new null. And I bring all the tubes in this null, and the null under the subdivision surface. And when I activate now the subdivision surface, we have everything here beveled, nicely beveled. And with NI, you can show the isoparams, and you see we have a nice topology here. Okay, this is this. Now, I simply make of each of our tube nulls here, I make an instance. So I go to my tube one here and make an instance and drag it under the tube here so they are together, and I rotate this instance 180 degrees in this direction. So that means now, I'll show you later what I do, or I can show it now. I want now a small espresso, but we don't do the espresso ourselves. We make a small espresso like this. I go to the tube here, and in the coordinates, I want the rotation B. This is this rotation here, you see? This is the rotation we need. I right-click on this rotation, the espresso, set driver. And now I want to make the same rotation on the instance, the tube instance here. So I go here, I click on this B here so that not everything is selected. Right click here, and here under espresso, set driven absolute. So, yeah, it takes everything here, this is not what I want. It shouldn't do it. Let's see what the espresso says. Oh, where is my espresso window? Oh, here. This shouldn't be like this. Delete this. Espresso set driven absolute. Now, the B, I have to do it, I think. So bring the instance back to 180 degrees here. And now when I rotate this tube here in the B-axis, you see what happens? Because we rotated the instance 180 degrees, it rotates now in the opposite direction, and so we just have to animate. We have a small problem. Let's bring this back and make this whole express on you. Something went wrong here. My problem was I did not click on the I need to click on the B here. Now I go to the expressor, set driver. Here then instant on the B, set driven absolute. And now this should work probably correct. Let's see. Now it works, you see? Okay, so be careful, just click here on the B, right click on the B and expression set driver on the tube, and here again on the B set driven absolute, and you're done. This is the only expressor we've done, and you have to do nothing with expressor anymore. So yeah, a little bit, but this is, you will see, this is a very very small thing. So make the same with the tube too, and make an instance of tube 2. So instance, bring it under tube 2. Here I simply copy this expression tag with control, drag it on the instance 2. Now I open it, and the only thing I have to do here is, yeah, this is it. Come on. Yeah, it doesn't matter. Okay. Good. The only thing I have to do here, you see, I have here tube 2. Instance 2, this is a correct, but we have here tube 1. So what we have to do here, just drag the tube 2 here into this field here on rotation B. Now you see tube 2, and that's all we have to do. Now we make the same with tube 3. Tube 3, make an instance. Bring it under the tube 3 here, copy this expression tag here, double click on it, so we have here tube 3, you see it, and we need tube 3 here as well. That's it, that's always expressed, so we don't have to do nothing anymore. So this one 180 degrees, this one 180 degrees, zoop. And this should now work everywhere. So when we take the tube 3 and work this here, work tube 2, oops, works. Great. Let's make the tube 2 here and the tube instance and rotate them. Oops. I want to rotate them just in this direction, 90 degrees. Okay. This should still work now. Yep. Okay. So far, so good. Let's save it. And now we need just in the middle here a cylinder. Let's put in a cylinder here. No, no, no. Where's the cylinder here? Okay. With NH, I bring back my wireframe so I can see what I have here. Go to my object, bring it plus Y, height of 10 centimeter, 40 centimeter radius, this was the small radius of this inner circle here, and bring it 5 high, so okay. But what I don't like here is, I want to bring this in a cylinder like that too, but I don't want to make too many. I want quads. I will take and make this with 8. Yeah. Let's hide the other ones for the moment here. I want quads in the middle. So let's go to my cylinder, make it editable. See on the keyboard. Point mode, this point and this point. MS for bevel, and I bevel this up a little bit. Okay. And here I go in the top view, take the knife with KK. I want a single line, and what's important, visible only, unchecked. I want to cut through the whole thing here, from here to here, and from here to here. Okay, that's it. Now I should have the cut here and here. Now we have just quads, you see, it's all quads. I take this cylinder and copy it. Bring it to minus 5. Okay, perfect. And bring this in the null as well. So, this is our cylinder. And this cylinder I bring to our subdivision surface as well. But you see, okay, this looks not correct now here for me. For you maybe too. So what I do here now is so let's hide this, let's hide, I'll bring it out for the moment here and hide this again. What I want to do is to bevel these guys here as well. But with the bevel deformer, it's possible, so sure, when I put the bevel deformer in here, you see when I put it under the null, so it affects both of our cylinders. But then I go now to solid. We get this edge here, so when I put this in a subdivision surface, we don't get, you see, we don't get a circle, we don't get a cylinder, we get this 8-sided thing here. So when I bring go to the here the uniform, we get this that does not look better as well. So we have to do here some a little bit. First, deactivate this one and delete this one. And so I go to my cylinder here, edge mode, and select a loop selection of this one, of this edge here, and this edge. You can double click on one edge here, and then you have a loop selection. Or use UL, you can make a loop selection too. Now we set, we save this selection. I make this a little bigger here, this is, you can see it better. So, okay. And here I have my set selection here. So I can store my selection. You see here the selection tag. You can also select set selection, you have it here as well. Okay. Good, now when I bevel this, bring it in, you see that does not work, but when I go to my bevel, and in the bevel I have a selection here. Drag my selection inside here. And now we get exactly what we want. We don't need the use angle. Now the bevel just bevels our stored edges here. And this is exactly what we want. At least what I want. So, now I can make a copy of this cylinder here. Bring it to minus 5. And everything works fine. Bring this cylinder out of this. I can delete this subdivision surface because I want everything under one subdivision surface. So bring this back. Whoops. See, now the only thing we have to do is now to make here, yeah, want a little more, so NI, so we see it better, and make these two cylinders a little bigger here. T for scale, and be careful here, don't scale in every direction. We want to scale only in the Z and in the X axis. So what you can do, you can go on our on your Y axis here and hold the Shift key. So you see the other two become white. Or you go to this small arrow here. So, but in this case, I think it's the easiest way here. And now I just make this a little bigger so that the light sees this. Looks now perfect for me. And we are done. Save it and yeah. That looks almost really not bad. So now let's make these animation things. Good, you're here. This is ready. Good. Go to our first tube here. Coordinates, and here I click on my. I've started, I don't know how many frames. We want to rotate 180 degrees, everything, and then again 180 degrees back. So let's try it with 500 frames for now. And what I want to do is we have rotated this tube, the second tube here, 90 degrees, you see. So let's make the same with the cylinder, so that the cylinder rotates then in this direction. So, oops, back, minus 90 or plus 90, however you want. So, save, and now, tube one, frame, I start on 1 second, 25. I have 25 frames a second, so I start after 1 second. Click on my on my keyframe, then frame, let's give it 2 seconds, 75, and go to 180 degrees and click again on my keyframe. Okay, but normally I make my when I make a loop or something else, I every time I use a linear interpolation of the V curve, so of the keyframe of the curve. But here now I do not really have a loop like this, so I want to make a ease depression. So I go to here, go to animation, show track. I have here now our track. So, yipsie. And here under the rotation I see the curve, the F curve. This is a linear curve. I think the default there is an ease curve, so maybe you don't have to change this. But for me, I select it and I go here to this ease here. Now I see, okay, this is what I want here. And let's see how this looks. Now let's deactivate the subdivision surface here. Yeah, maybe. In there here for the moment, because it runs faster when we do. So, I want it a little slower at the beginning and at the ending, and a little faster in the middle. So, what I do is select this one point here, and here I have the tangent. I make it a little longer. So let's say. Minus 20. You see the 20 here is okay, that's bad. And we have a longer tangent here. Same I do now here. Minus 20. And now it should be slower at the beginning and a little quicker in the middle. Zoop. Yeah, that's far better. Okay. Now I want the same animation on the other tubes, but a little is the frame, so let's make this, go to this tube here. I right click on, no, just to be here. That selects everything, so be careful that you just have to be here. I click on it and stay on it and say copy track. Okay, now I go to tube two. And paste track. So now when I go to the view, automatic view, I have now here tube 2, select just these two and drag it, let's say 25, so however you want, you can do it however you want, maybe let Finnish one and start with the second one on 75, however you want, but I make it a little shorter so you don't have to render so much. Tube 3, so animation, paste track, select this too and go to 75 here and let's see what we get. Zoop, zoop, zoop. Perfect. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Now let's bring in the cylinder too. But I don't activate this the subdivision surface for the moment. We can do this later on. So just to have a fluent animation for now in the viewport. Good, so let's go to the cylinder. And yeah, the same on the cylinder. We need just to paste. So again, I click a left click on the on this point here, and stay on I stay on my mouse button until this window comes, and then I'm still on my mouse button. I'm still on my mouse button, and now I paste track. And now I release my mouse button. So take this too and bring it to here. That should work. Zoop, 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 zoop. Perfect. Maybe I think this goes in the wrong direction, but it's maybe better to look like this. Ah, that's okay. That's, I like it. And then when we are finished, we want to make this whole thing in the different direction, the opposite direction, of course. Good. Let's see how we can do this. Go to our tube 1 and yeah, I want to show it with the curve here. I go to my tube 1, control, hold my control key and drag this whole thing here with the control tree. We copy this, so here the cylinder is ready with this rotation. But we could start here in the middle again. This 25 looks good for me. Okay. But now you see we have in the wrong direction. We need the last two keys here. We need to mirror them so that it comes down here again. So we have them selected here, these two. And now we go to the key. And there is a function named mirror. Mirror X. X. Now you see this is exactly what we want. It comes down again. And we need the mirror on the other things too. So what you can do, you don't have, because you see you don't have really a shortcut here. But what I want to do is bring it in the toolbar here. So you can do this. Or is this the mirror? No, this is key thing. Okay. Shift F12, customize commands. I say mirror X, here we have it. And I drag this simply on this bar here. Now I have it here. Let's make an icon separator. And so you can make your whole toolbars and everything, but don't forget to save the then customize and save it as whatever you want. So. Okay, now let's go to tube 2. Control drag this to here, and we have this selected. Just click on the mirror X. Okay, so let's see if it worked. And it worked, you see, the mirror is okay. Tube 3, control, drag this guy here to here, mirror it, and last but not least, our cylinder, and mirror it. So we need 250, not 500, 250, save it. So let's see what we get here. Zim, 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 zim. Okay, nice. And it starts from the beginning. Good, now we can bring our subdivision surface in. Let's make a nice floor, let's color this whole thing, and we are ready. Good, so the floor. How can we make the floor? I will do it with a spline mask. Yeah, why not? I take a spline rectangle. I want a rectangle on the floor, so tricky. I'll make it from the top view, that's better. Make it here 2000 by 2000. Very big, but it's okay. And I want a circle spline. And we know this outer radius should be 130. Going perfect. So let's hide this for the moment. We have here, I think, and now we'll make a spline mask. So we want to combine these two masks. I could combine it like this. I could select them and connect and delete. But I want to be able to change this later a little bit, this hole or something else. So this is the reason I want to use a spline mask here. So spline mask, drag both splines inside. See, okay, this is not what we want. We want it in the Y direction. So spline along Y, and Y is our hole away. And our hole is here. So next step, extrude this thing here. Select the spline mask, go to Alt click on extrude, Alt makes the extrude apparent of the spline mask. This is the wrong direction. Yeah, I see minus 200, something else to see. Okay, we get something nice with the hole. I don't like this thing here. Let's make the circle here. Go to adaptive and... Okay, that's nice. That's okay. And let's bring back this here. So, okay, of course, with our 10 at high here, so we are in that's okay for me. And I want to make something like I will show you what I want to do is bring my spline mask here up to 8 centimeters. So we are here on zero. The spline mask is here on the floor, direct on Y zero. I bring it 8 high. Okay. Now I copy this spline mask, control, drag it down. Under the extrude is okay. And here I want to extrude this spline. No, I need a new spline mask. I cannot do this with. So I bring it out of this extrude. Cannot do this with one extrude because you want here. Another extrude. Here my spline mask. Another extrude. And this I want to extrude up 2 centimeters. So that means it should be okay. So now I have two extrudes, and so it looks like I had a plate or something else on this whole thing. When we now bring these two extrudes in a null here. Whoop, and bevel this now. These two extrudes, so go to bevel deformer, but a very small bevel here. So I make it here with an offset of 0.2 and maybe 3 here. 0.5. Oh, 0.5 looks a little better. And you see, we have here now a nice. Think this is exactly what I want. Save it. So, we are almost done here. So this is our floor. Oh, drag it down, floor is down here, so save it. Bring back our things, this should fit here perfectly. Yep, that does fit perfect. So, something like this. See how this looks. Yep. Great. I like this. It looks very satisfying. So, okay, save it. And I want to make here something like a floor. This is nothing easier than that. Bring in plane. E. Drag it down. So, okay, that's enough. Plane, not with plates. Okay. Yeah, now we could start. I will do this with the with obtain render, but I've now shown so often how to use to do something like this in the physical render. So please, if you don't know how to do it in physical render or how to texture in physical render, please watch one of my other tutorials. So I show it 100 times. I don't know how many tutorials I have now. I think I have 270 tutorials or something else. And I'm sure there are 100 tutorials only for how you can texture. So please be so kind. I think it's not really necessary to every time make it for physical render and octane render. Because I do it for physical render and octane render when it comes to things where modeling is important, for where I have to model something for, let's say, because of displacement or something else. I need more in physical render. I need more subdivisions for displacement as in octane render. Of course, then I will show it for both renders, but not for something like this. This is. I think if you are not agree with me, please let me know. So, of course, I will do however you want, but let me know if you don't agree with me. So, save it and bring in the zip-to-do. And now I start to make the floor. Yeah. So let's make a wood floor, a wood. Cylinder here and a black floor or something else. I think this is okay. Good. Wood material. Let's go to my Octane dialog. Materials open live database. This needs sometimes a little time, but it comes. When it comes. Ah, come on. I don't know why it takes so much time. Yeah, of course, I have a lot into it, but it should be. So I have my Nikon media material pack here. If you're a patron, you can download it from my Patreon site. And this whole update, this will come next year. So, I tried everything to make it this year, but it was too much work. Sorry. So what could look funny? Let's try this here. Download it and drag it on our floor. Oh, wait. This is the big floor. This is the top of the floor. So okay, extrude here. Okay, then let's see how this looks. This is not. Yeah, that looks funny. Maybe a little too big, and we need some light here. So my Nikon Media Scenery. We don't need here a floor. Shadow catcher off. Okay, I don't really need a background is off, it's okay. So let's see what we can do in the material here. Note that it and it's still adds a round edge here. I don't know why. This is not in the original one. Displacement is okay. You can bring up the displacement, but I think this is okay. Maybe a little smaller, this whole thing. So I make an RGB here. Transform. I want to transform every image. So go to this and to this. This is the big advantage of a node-based system here. I don't know why here is a color. This is, I did for sure not make this with color. I used for sure a float. So, something like that. And maybe a little smaller, this whole thing here. Yeah, this I like more. And it looks like it tiles. I don't like tiles, but this. Okay, so make it a little bigger so we don't have the tiles. Make another material, a simple glossy material, I would say. Glossy, glossy, glossy. Again, note that it. So we need something for our floor here. RGB spectrum, so. Black color, almost black. Some roughness. I will take a scratch map for the roughness. Top, so you see that works. But what I want is flat protection on this. So I go here to flat protection. And I wanna see, so with NQ you can disable the textures here. You see we have here some, this is from this from the spline mask here. This we have some ugly things here. Let's see if we can make this a little nicer. Zero here. Yeah, that's the way. Okay. Good. Then, yeah, I want a flat mapping asset. Let's see if it's flat mapped. So I select my material here and go in material of material view here. So material here. You see that it's not in the correct position. So I rotate it. R rotation. Rotate it like this. 90 degrees, then come on. So, okay, now it's okay. And right click on it and mix in our fit to object. Yep, now it's exactly as big as the floor. Okay, the flat protection is because I want to make some dust or some scratches or something else. Load the detail again and bring in here. I have here on my other monitor some maps open. Let's take this one. Check just an image in here, you see. You can download later on, the patrons can download the project file, of course, so you get the texture too. And bring this in the roughness channel. See, okay. We want to transform this a little bit. It seems a little too big for me. Yeah, that looks nice. Good to bring this in a bump map as well. Oh, this is too much, but we can bring between the bump map and the image texture a color correction. Come on, you're not texture color correction and go down here a little with anything you don't want, with the brightness maybe. Okay, good. And I think I want on the I make the same thing on the floor, so I'm a little lazy, so whoops, bring this on the plane here. And I want for sure another HDRI here. So this is Studio HDRI. Shift F8 for content browser. And I don't think I want the Studio. Let's see if I want something in. And mostly I take the same pictures here. And most of you know it meanwhile. Where is it? So here somewhere. This one or this one. This is more brighter. Looks cool, but let's take this here. It's so easy to work with this rig. Okay, I have to say it, I know. We could add a little sun here. And maybe late. Or we just make it a little brighter here. Save this. Now I go to now we make something for the tubes. So let's hide the floor for the moment. Bring in our things here, our tubes here. And yeah, some colors. Now we make some very simple, only color material. So material, glossy material. This down here, so. I want GGX here. I want GGX here as well. I want normally everywhere GGX. It's okay. Color. This is up here, so. GP spectrum. And some roughness. This should be fine. Bring this on my first tube here. And the funny thing is, normally it should not on the tube. I need on one of the tubes here. You see, now it's one is here and one is here on the instance, and exactly on the opposite side. This is exactly what I want. And let's see if we find some nice colors here. Let's load. Let's see if we find something here. Here you can add some your own. Maybe I show it sometime. You can make your own collections here. Let's take something like this for the moment too. So let's bring drag it just in this panel here. So then I go to my texture here, control drag it down, so we'll make a copy of it. Zack, take another color here and drag this to this guy here. So really do not really care now about the colors. So sorry for that, but okay, next color. This maybe. Or if so, first I have to open this guy. Check. Copy it. Take this one here. The other side. Yeah, that looks not bad. Copy it. Poof. Take one of this here, maybe. Oops. Open the third one here. Dumb. Copy this one. We have this already. Let's see. This one here. Okay, and now two colors for the cylinders. Yeah, let's make maybe this two blue. No, let's see. I want to see something. This is a little too heavy. Maybe this here. This blue and this green, maybe. So, this blue. And last but not least. Greenish thing here. So, save this. We have everything here, so let's clean the floor. And I think I will render, but I delete here the bump. Because you can do it with the bumpers. With the bump, we get this. So it would need longer to render, so we get rid of this. But I think with the denoiser, the denoiser should kill something of this. Let's try it. Bring an octane object like this. Octane camera. So. Whoop. Camera image, enable camera image, denoiser, enable denoiser, and let's see what the denoiser does. Yeah, the denoiser kills it. Okay, so let it in. It looks nice. And I will render this 250 frames, and I'm back when it's done. So, see you in a second. I may be a little down here, so. Maybe let's make a little depth of field too, so that we don't see this. So let's go to focus and focus in the middle of here. So I'll focus on this one here. Okay, and let's go to no, scene lengths, and here let's go to depth of field, go up here a little bit, now we get some depth of field in the background here, yeah, save it, okay, so. And yeah, I'm back in a second for you, and we hope for a nice result. See you, and yeah. So we are ready, and let's see what we got here. Wink, yep. got a really nice animation, if you ask me. I like it. Nice. Yeah, that's it. Yeah, I really like it. And you see, it was not really hard to do, but it's a little work, of course, with the keyframes, copy keyframes, move keyframes a little around. But that's it. So you get quite fast a really nice thing here. Yep. So I think this will be my last one for this year. Yeah, but year is not long anymore. Yes, and I want to say really thank you to all of you, to all my followers, to all of all of you, and especially to my patrons and people who donated. Really, a really big thanks. And it's honestly, it really makes fun for you to do it for you. So I get really 99% get positive messages and yeah, just friendly things and nice things, and I really love it. So it makes still fun, and next year we will continue, of course. And next year I have some things, some ideas. We will do some live streams. We will do some, I don't know, maybe a little more complicated things, because we are now little advanced users. And for patrons, I will do some special tutorials. And for patrons, I have some ideas for patrons. I don't know how to do it. I do not really have a plan, but I have some ideas, and I want to do that. And yeah, and I also plan to visit Germany next year. So I will tell you this, because maybe we can make some meeting somewhere. Or don't know. I will write everything on my home on my website, and and of course on Facebook and everywhere, and I will tell it in the tutorial, so you will get a message. Maybe we have time, maybe we find together someone in Germany or Croatia or somewhere, I don't know. Or in Switzerland, or I really don't know, I cannot tell it. But I have some plans and a lot of ideas. So I wish you all a wonderful new year, and yeah, and lot of fun, and much success, and all the best here from Austria, of course. And yeah, if I said, and if you want to donate, you will find every link in the description for donation or PayPal, or if you want to support me on Patreon, you can do so. You will find every link, and I really appreciate that. And yeah, if you have questions, complaints, requests, whatever, you can reach me over here, over the comments, you know it, meanwhile, comments, website, Facebook, blah, 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 blah. You know it, you will find me, and I promise I try to answer really every single question, but sometimes it takes a little longer, sometimes I overlook something, so please try it again. And that's it for now. Really, wish you a happy new year, a great time, and all the best from the bottom of my heart. Thank you so much for watching my tutorials. And now, yeah, tschüss und baba.